All right, good afternoon on the Purple Couch family. This is Bahia. I am in the beautiful Harare, Zimbabwe, with the man himself. I am exploring the creative life of Craig Zuwe. I want to introduce you all to my new friend and real person of heart. Really cool.
Spirit animal.
I think so. Craig, say hi to the OTPC family.
Hi, everyone. It's a pleasure meeting you and everyone. Yeah.
So Craig and I did a podcast. Make sure you guys follow that. You know I'm on Instagram. You know all the places I'm in. But I wanted to do a video, just one, to make sure the podcast worked, too. For you guys to kind of see him, get a sense a little bit about Zimbabwe. You know we're on summer break, but we also are working, because when you're an entrepreneur, you can't take 2 weeks off and smoke it. You just can't. So we're doing some work. Craig, you have this awesome creative life in Zimbabwe. A beautiful, clear, we're in the wintertime, guys, which means it's about 72 Fahrenheit in the day. It goes down to 40 at night. We're in Southern Africa, okay? Craig is an event planner, high corporate events, private sector, public sector. He also has a clothing line that he designs. He also has a teaching and apprenticeship and a master class in events. That is an amazing experience for people here to learn from somebody who has studied and has served in so many venues. He also events, styling, food styling, and anybody knows. See, this is the thing about creative life. I just want to say this. You know, food styling is a big deal. Not to get off target, eh? It's a big deal.
It is a big deal, yeah. That food needs to look on point.
Hello?
Yep.
Yeah. You know, I am on social media, and I'm taking us left, but it's really still on the same thing about a creative life. Styling is important. Styling of your home, just like, you know, you're getting ready to go out to dinner with your partner. That's important. But if you are a chef, if you are in clothes, if you are in pottery, if you are in sewing, right?
Definitely.
Right?
It's about styling. The aesthetics. Yeah.
What's styling? What is it? What am I talking about?
Styling basically is the aesthetics, how anything looks. If it's the food, how the food is presented on the plate, you know. If it's a dessert station, how is that dessert station looking? Exactly. What are the colors, you exactly. know? What sort of linens have been used there? What sort of florals mm-hmm. are in there? What sort of aesthetic?
Yes.
When it's your home, what message do you want to send to your guests when yes. they come into your home? Do you want it to be a home or you want it to be a showroom? What pieces have you used? What textures? Mm-hmm. You know, your furs, your chevron mm-hmm. patterns, your stripes.
And I have a lot of lace and pearls, people, so I'm not leaving you out. Lace and pearls.
Lace and pearls.
Throw them in there.
Definitely. So it's
your shabby chic.
You know.
You've got them.
Yeah, so it's about how anything looks. You know, that sort of lifestyle where you're saying to the world, this is who I am. These are the things that I love. Mm-hmm. You know, when you walk into my home, what are you going to find in there
right.
that
right.
can tell a story about who you are?
Right.
You know.
And Craig, let me interrupt right there. So we're not talking about a over the top, you know, having somebody descend from the sky type of styling. We're talking about styling that presents who you are.
Definitely.
Any designer that you work with, you guys know if you come into the shop, you ask about a color consultation or a consultation about how to design a particular piece. The first thing I'm saying is, what do you like, right? Isn't that important?
That's very, very important.
I do want, when I have a Craig Zuwe event, I want a Craig Zuwe event, but I want it to be Bahia, right?
Definitely, yeah, definitely. So, definitely when you have a consultation with myself or any of the partners at work, we'll ask you. We definitely need to meet with you so that we understand your character, because that is what we want to project in your event.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's when we bring in aspects of who Craig Zuwe is, where I'm saying to you, so this is your mood board, this is what I feel is here.
Right.
You know, your lace, your pearls, mm-hmm. that sort of thing. What do you like? Do you want mm-hmm. ethnic tones, that sort of vibe? And then obviously after the mood board, you can then direct us to say, no, maybe a little bit more of this, mm-hmm. less of that.
Okay.
Because we're creating Bahia.
Mm-hmm.
And then by the time your event comes to life, mm-hmm. when you walk in there, even your guests, you know, they are wowed by Bahia as an event.
Exactly.
Exactly. Working with your budget and the pieces that you love of our image.
Right. And Craig has a Pinterest page. As you know, we have a Pinterest page. Those are all places where you can get inspiration for your events. Now, we're talking about for me, events are not just, you know, they start at 9, they end at 4. Events is your own home, your own, you know, your guest bathroom. That's an event, if you will, or a styling space, right? A space.
Yeah.
And not something that is false, fake, full. It is you, whomever the customer is. The other thing I want to talk to you about is collaborating as a business person. What's your take on collaborating and what is that?
Okay, collaborations are very healthy for each creative and for each business. There's no way I could say I'm Craig, I know it all. I collaborate with photographers. They know angles. I'll show them a mood board of how I want my table done, short. They'll say to me, that shot is going to be possible or impossible. That's their area of expertise. I can collaborate with another fashion designer who specializes in haute couture, because maybe our client is attending a high-end haute couture type of event. So collaborations are always helpful because it's great teamwork. And also the market is so big, you can't own the market on your own. And then when you do collaborate with different aspects of industries like that, you know, different masters of the industry, it sort of gets all of you out there, unlike when you do it on your own, you know. So all of you are now out there. We've met.
Right.
Oh, guys, stay tuned. So you see, it's things like that where we create much more than ourselves, you know. So it's always very important to collaborate with different people here and there. Yeah, find out how they're doing things. They learn from you and that sort of thing, yeah.
One of the things in terms of collaboration, I want to talk about the power of social media, and I think we'll end with that. You know, you guys know that we're on social media everywhere. What I love about Instagram, I'm not working for them, they haven't done anything for me. What I love about Instagram is that I can sit now in Zimbabwe and type in my search, New York City, Queens, and Instagram pictures will take me to that space. One of the things I do with little Edward, my son, is show him life of Africa, even when we're home. So on Instagram, I'll put in Senegal, Dakar, and I'll flip through the pictures, and I'll flip through cities and life, right? Mm-hmm. So city life, which is city life like any contemporary city.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll do village life, rural life, and then he'll see sort of the stereotypical pictures of Africa.
Yeah.
But he sees both. Like, I love that I can take myself to a particular space and talk about collaborating. These are some of the things that I saw on Craig's Instagram, and I hope you guys are inspired by his Instagram, and you see not only events, but the application to whatever your creative life is about, that you can come to Harare, Zimbabwe without getting on the plane through the eyes of Craig Zui, the creative life, and other people. There's also Rafario, I keep talking about her because I was in her shop, but there's other people that you can search, any topics that you're interested in. So in terms of collaborate with the world that we have. Our world is so alive. I'm not preaching to anybody, just confirming what has been a good experience for me. Craig, I want to thank you for doing this. There's one thing that was on the podcast. Craig says stay in your lane, okay? Stay in your lane. 2017, you got a couple more months. Stay in your lane. What does it mean, stay in your lane? Take your specialty and knock it out.
Yep, definitely.
Am I right?
Own it. Wear it like a crown.
That's it.
Yep.
Thank you so much, Craig.
No, thank you for having me.
OPTC family, please share with your friends. You know, I don't know what this is about. I don't know what's next for us, but you know you guys are always with me. Thank you for all the support. So this is Bahia in Harare, Zimbabwe.